ladies and gentlemen, the President of the United States and the Prime Minister of the Republic of Italy.
Thank you very much. Prime Minister Gentiloni, welcome. Great honor. Thank you. It's wonderful to have you in our wonderful People's House, known as the White House. And so many great Italian friends are with us today. And we renew always the deep ties of history and friendship that link together the American and the Italian peoples. That history traces its roots to the timeless contributions of Italy to civilization and human progress, so true. Stretching all the way back to ancient Rome, through the ages, your country has been a beacon of artistic and scientific achievement. That continues today. From Venice to Florence, from Verdi to Pavarotti, a friend of mine, great friend of mine. These bonds of history and culture have only grown stronger as our two nations have become close partners, dear friends, and very vital allies. Mr. Prime Minister, I'm thrilled that you are here today to discuss how we can make this great relationship even more productive in the years to come. On the economy, Italy is one of America's largest trading partners. A lot of people don't know that. We both seek a trading relationship that is balanced, reciprocal. I love the word reciprocal, because we don't have too many reciprocal trading partnerships, I will tell you that, but we will very soon. And fair, benefiting both of our countries, and we can work together to achieve that outcome, and that will happen. Italy is also a key partner in the fight against terrorism. Italy is now the second largest contributor of troops to the conflicts in Iraq and Afghanistan. I would also like to thank you, Prime Minister, for your leadership on seeking stabilization in Libya and for your crucial efforts to deny ISIS a foothold in the Mediterranean. You fought hard. We're grateful for your role in the anti-ISIS campaign. All nations must condemn this barbaric enemy and support the effort to achieve its total and complete destruction. Also, as you know, Mr. Prime Minister, we have more than 30,000 American service members, families, and personnel who are stationed across your country. As we reaffirm our support for historic institutions, we must also reaffirm the requirement that everyone must pay their full and fair share for the cost of defense. Together, we can address many pressing challenges, including two that greatly affect both of our countries, those of large-scale migration and international smuggling. Maintaining strong borders is a vital component of any security policy. And a responsible approach to refugees is one that seeks the eventual return of refugees to their home countries so that they can help to rebuild their own nations. Finally, I want to say how much I look forward to visiting Sicily for the G7 as we seek to foster cooperation, not only in matters of security, but also science, commerce, health, and technology. Our two countries have shared interests and shared values, and we can each make great contributions to the other. Mr. Prime Minister, I again want to thank you for being with us and being our true friend. Italy is a spectacular place. I know it well. I love the people of Italy. We have 18 million Italians living in the United States, people originally from Italy. And it's a great honor to have many of them as my friends. Thank you for being here.
Thank you, Mr. President. Thank you for hosting us here. I'm honored to be here at the White House today. And I'll now switch to Italian. Abbiamo avuto un incontro molto fruttuoso.
We had a very fruitful meeting.
Che riflette un'antica amicizia,
which
come
reflects
ha
an
ricordato
ancient friendship,
con le sue parole,
as
il Presidente
the
Trump.
President reminded us with his words.
Un'amicizia testimoniata
this friendship
anche da quei 18 milioni
is
di
also
americani di origine
a sign of the 18 million Italian Americans who have such an important
paese.
Role in our country, in this country.
Testimoniata anche
and
da
this friendship is witnessed
fatto che
also
è
by
la
the fact that Italy is the second choice for American students who study abroad. And we're very proud of this. And this confirms the importance
che negli Stati Uniti viene data
that
alla dimensione
the United States
culturale
gives
del nostro
to
paese,
the cultural
così
dimension
come è stato
of our country.
Ricordato.
Oggi as the President himself just said,
si fonda this
friendship
comune contro
is based
il terrorismo,
on a common commitment against terrorism.
Impegno che ci vede
this commitment
come paese molto attivi,
in
particolare
in,
in
which
Iraq
we
e in
are both very active. Our country is very
credo
active
che saremo
in Iraq
decisivi
and in Afghanistan, and I think
di stabilizzazione
that the stabilization work will be decisive.
Dopo la
stabilization
sconfitta
work
militare
of Iraq
che ci
after
auguriamo
the military defeat that we expected for Daesh.
Questa azione contro il terrorismo deve essere svolta anche all'interno dei nostri paesi, in Europa,
in Europe,
con l'impegno sociale e culturale contro la radicalizzazione, collaborando anche con le comunità islamiche. L'Italia contribuisce alla pace e alla stabilità nel Mediterraneo,
in Siria,
dove credo sia stata giusta la scelta degli Stati Uniti di reagire all'uso di armi chimiche da parte di Bashar al-Assad, dove più che mai necessaria una soluzione
and where
negoziale.
A negotiated solution
Libia,
is more necessary than ever.
Abbiamo
in
discusso
Libya,
nel nostro
and
incontro,
this in our meeting,
dove si tratta di lavorare contro la divisione del paese per la stabilizzazione. Un compito tra l'altro decisivo per riuscire a gestire i flussi
if we want
migratori
to flows,
senza rinunciare
without
ai nostri valori
up on our values
e ai principi umanitari
and our humanitarian
e contrastando l'ignobile traffico
and we need
dei
to contrast the
e dei clandestini.
Horrible traffic
l'Italia
of
è
people and clandestine refugees.
Italy
is convinced of its strategic commitment in favor of the transatlantic relationship.
Anche affrontato
we
i temi
have
dell'impegno
also
comune nella NATO,
spoken about common commitments in NATO
gli obiettivi individuati nel
and the goals
2014,
that were identified in 2014 and the commitments on military expenses and the contribution that each country must make towards collective security.
Siamo orgogliosi
we are proud
contributo.
Of our contribution.
L'Italia infine è il paese
and finally,
del dialogo.
Italy is a country of dialogue.
Siamo fieri di essere riusciti
we are proud
a tenere aperte
because we succeeded
porte
in
anche
keeping
di fronte
open
a crisi
the doors and difficult crises.
E il dialogo può essere utile
dialogue can be
anche nei confronti
useful
della Russia.
Even vis-à-vis
ovviamente
Russia,
senza rinunciare
without
alla nostra
obviously
unità,
giving up
senza
our
rinunciare ai nostri principi,
and our principles,
senza rinunciare alla nostra
without
forza
giving up
e ai
our
nostri
strength
valori.
And our values.
Ho infine rappresentato al Presidente Trump la nostra
President Trump
fiducia,
that
sia pure in un momento
have
difficile,
even though this is a difficult moment, and we all know it's difficult right now.
Nel futuro dell'Unione Europea,
we have confidence in the future of the European Union,
e certamente nell'importanza delle relazioni tra Stati Uniti e Europa.
Importance
sono
of
i due
the relationship
pilastri
between the US and Italy. These are the
two
pillars that
la relazione transatlantica
the transatlantic
è molto
relationship
della
is based on
pace, della libertà
great part of peace and freedom in the world.
Stiamo attraversando un momento
we are going through a difficult time,
ma io ho fiducia che l'Unione Europea possa continuare a essere una risposta
will continue
positiva.
To be a positive
e infine,
response
to
this.
And finally, siamo in attesa di poter accogliere il Presidente
we are expecting and are
e la First
forward to the President's visit
a Taormina per
to the
il
summit
G7.
In Taormina.
confido che sarà un'occasione per mostrare l'unità dei leader delle principali economie libere del perché di questa planet. Unità c'è in questo
Because
momento davvero
right now,
molto bisogno.
Really do need this unity.
Di nuovo, grazie,
again,
signor
Presidente. Thank you, Mr.
President.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Appreciate it. Take a few questions. John Roberts of Fox, please.
Mr. President, thank you much. I hope you'll forgive me for asking you a three-part question. It's been a while. In just the last few minutes, and I believe it was while you were meeting with the Prime Minister, there was a shooting in downtown Paris. It's
that.
Being described as a potential terrorist attack. I wonder if you have something on that. And further to that, two of the big trouble spots that you're dealing with right now, North Korea and Iran. Do you believe that the leader of North Korea, Kim Jong-un, is mentally unstable? Is that one of the reasons why you're so concerned about these latest developments? Is he a man who can be reasoned with? And on Iran, do you have reason to suspect that they are cheating on the JCPOA? And to Mr. Prime Minister, you talked just a moment ago about your commitment to NATO. President Trump would like to see all NATO members contribute 2% of their GDP to NATO. Your contribution is slightly less than 1%. Will you commit to committing 2% of your GDP to the alliance going forward? Thank you.
Well, first of all, I love the question you asked the Prime Minister. I look forward to his answer, because I'm going to be asking him that same question very soon. Well, first of all, our condolences from our country to the people of France. Again, it's happening, it seems. I just saw it as I was walking in, so that's a terrible thing. And it's a very, very terrible thing that's going on in the world today. But it looks like another terrorist attack. And what can you say? It just never ends. And we have to be strong and we have to be vigilant. And I've been saying it for a long time. As far as North Korea is concerned, we are in very good shape. We're building our military rapidly. A lot of things have happened over the last short period of time. I've been here for approximately 91 days. We're doing a lot of work. We're in very good position. We're going to see what happens. I can't answer your question on stability. I hope the answer is a positive one, not a negative one. But hopefully that will be something that gets taken care of. I have great respect for the president of China. As you know, we had a great summit in Florida and Palm Beach and got to know each other, and I think like each other. I can say from my standpoint, I liked him very much. I respect him very much. And I think he's working very hard. I can say that all of the pundits out there are saying they never have seen China work like they're working right now. Many coal ships have set back. Many other things have happened. Some very unusual moves have been made over the last 2 or 3 hours. And I really have confidence that the president will try very hard. We don't know whether or not they're able to do that, but I have absolute confidence that he will be trying very, very hard. And one of the reasons that we're talking about trade deals and we're talking about all of the different things, but we're slowing up a little bit. I actually told him, I said, you'll make a much better deal on trade if you get rid of this menace or do something about the menace of North Korea, because that's what it is. It's a menace right now. So we'll see what happens. As far as Iran is concerned, I think they are doing a tremendous disservice to an agreement that was signed. It was a terrible agreement. It shouldn't have been signed. It shouldn't have been negotiated the way it was negotiated. I'm all for agreements, but that was a bad one, as bad as I've ever seen negotiated. They are not living up to the spirit of the agreement, I can tell you that. And we're analyzing it very, very carefully, and we'll have something to say about it in the not-too-distant future. But Iran has not lived up to the spirit of the agreement. And they have to do that. They have to do that. So we will see what happens. Thank you very much, John.
Thank you, Mr. President. Prima di tutto,
first of all,
lasciatemi associare alle parole del Presidente Trump per quello che è successo a Parigi, parole di condoglianza, di vicinanza
words
al popolo e al governo francese, tra l'altro in un momento molto delicato, siamo a tre giorni dalle elezioni. Per quanto riguarda la domanda, l'impegno è stato preso,
in un vertice della NATO,
e noi siamo abituati a mantenere gli
impegni.
Sappiamo che sarà un processo graduale, questo processo è già iniziato. Sappiamo che l'Italia ha delle restrizioni di bilancio, ma nonostante queste restrizioni, il nostro impegno per la difesa comune è molto chiaro. E come ho detto prima, io sono orgoglioso non solo del progresso nel nostro impegno finanziario per la difesa comune, ma sono orgoglioso anche per il contributo che diamo alla sicurezza dell'alleanza in tantissime aree del mondo. Abbiamo parlato prima di Iraq e Afghanistan,
but we could also talk about the Baltic Sea or the Balkans.
In tutte queste aree troverete la presenza di forze italiane nell'alleanza, e di questo siamo orgogliosi.
And we are proud of that.
Giovanna
Pancalli, Sky News.
Italia, prima per lei, Presidente Gentiloni,
first for you, President Gentiloni, I wanted to ask you, we saw from this new administration a new type of policy on international scene, very different from what we had in the past, and one of the last important operations which was carried out by President Trump was in Syria with a bombing following the use of chemical weapons by the Assad regime. I wanted to ask you, does Italy think or conceive a possibility
more acting in Syria? A couple of questions, since my colleague from Fox News did, so I'm going to take as well the possibility to ask you two questions. First of all, about European Union. You have said in the past that Brexit was a great thing, and that you think that other countries will follow. So you know that Italy is an important player and supporter of European integration. Do you believe that actually a strong Europe is important for the United States, also looking forward at a French election? And then the second question is that you said that you're looking forward to come to Italy for the G7, and I wanted to know if you're also looking forward, if it's going to be possible to meet Pope Francis during your Italian trip. Thank you.
Siria. Noi Syria. Abbiamo giudicato immediatamente l'operazione ordinata dal Presidente Trump come una risposta motivata all'uso di armi chimiche. Abbiamo aggiunto che resta l'impegno di tutti a considerare il negoziato come la strada attraverso la quale si può arrivare auspicabilmente in questa infinita e drammatica guerra a una soluzione di pace. L'Italia non è impegnata direttamente nelle operazioni militari in Siria e se non per aspetti marginali che possiamo sempre discutere, non è nei nostri programmi di cambiare questo atteggiamento.
Our plan to change this attitude.
Yes, a strong Europe is very, very important to me as President of the United States, and it's also, in my opinion, in my very strong opinion, important for the United States. We want to see it. We will help it be strong. And it's very much to everybody's advantage, and I look very much forward to meeting the Pope. Fabian of the Hill, Fabian? Yes.
Thank you, Mr. President. Some people on Capitol Hill believe you can get one of two things next week, a vote on healthcare or a vote on a government funding bill. So my question is, which one is more important to you to have, a vote on healthcare or a vote on a bill to keep the government open? And Mr. Prime Minister, I want to get your thoughts on a referendum in Turkey that occurred last week. You spoke about democratic values in the European continent. So are you concerned with the results of the Turkish referendum? And is that something that you discussed with President Trump?
Okay, I want to get both. Are you shocked to hear that? And we're doing very well in healthcare. We'll see what happens. But this is a great bill. There's a great plan. and this will be great health care. It's evolving. You know, there was never a give up. The press sort of reported there was like a give up. There's no give up. We started. Remember, it took Obamacare 17 months. I've really been negotiating this for 2 months, maybe even less than that, because we had a 30-day period where we did lots of other things the first 30 days. But this has really been 2 months. And this is a continuation. And the plan gets better and better and better. And it's gotten really, really good. And a lot of people are liking it a lot. We have a good chance of getting it soon. I'd like to say next week, but it will be, I believe we will get it. And whether it's next week or shortly thereafter. As far as keeping the government open, I think we want to keep the government open. Don't you agree? So, yeah, I think we'll get both. Thank you.
Il referendum in Turchia è un fatto di cui dobbiamo prendere atto.
Is a fact that we must take note of.
Al di là delle discussioni che possono essere sollevate sulle modalità del voto,
ma credo che
le leadership europee abbiano preso atto del risultato del voto, le conseguenze dipenderanno molto dalla misura nella quale il governo turco, il presidente Erdogan in modo particolare, terranno conto di quella quasi metà della popolazione che si è espressa in modo diverso. Ci sarà un approccio inclusivo o ci sarà un approccio di scontro nei confronti di questa parte della Turchia? Questo sarà molto importante. Per noi della Unione Europea sarà molto importante anche il rispetto di alcuni principi fondamentali. Siamo parte dell'Alleanza Atlantica, l'Italia e la Turchia. L'Italia contribuisce alla difesa della Turchia con propri assetti militari. Pensiamo che tra i nostri paesi ci debba essere una collaborazione e speriamo, confidiamo che questa collaborazione abbia tra le sue conseguenze anche la soluzione del caso che riguarda il giornalista e il blogger detenuto da alcuni giorni, da diversi giorni in Turchia.
Giornale Radio. Italian Radio.
Italian Radio. Presidente Gentiloni, lei sta insistendo molto sulla relazione, sulla leadership italiana e americana per stabilizzare la Libia. Che cosa si aspetta esattamente da Washington? E soprattutto le chiedo che cosa è necessario in questo processo, un rapporto di collaborazione con la Russia, con President Trump. President Trump, do you see a role for your administration in helping stabilizing Libya? And do you agree that stabilizing Libya means combating terrorism and ISIS?
Ma l'America ha avuto un ruolo molto importante, innanzitutto per evitare che in Libia si consolidasse una base importante del terrorismo. Mentre il terrorismo di Daesh subiva delle sconfitte in Iraq e in Siria, ci sono state le operazioni che gli Stati Uniti hanno sostenuto contro Daesh nella città di Sirte, che hanno avuto un esito positivo. Ora l'impegno deve essere anche politico e quindi nella collaborazione tra Italia, Stati Uniti e altri partner fondamentali della regione, l'obiettivo è quello di allargare le basi di consenso all'attuale governo di Tripoli, che è riconosciuto dalla comunità internazionale, ma che deve poter contare su un consenso più largo. Un obiettivo, credo, debba essere molto chiaro. Noi abbiamo bisogno, ne ha bisogno la regione, ne hanno bisogno paesi come l'Egitto e la Tunisia, che sono vicini della Libia, di una Libia stabile e unita. Una Libia divisa e in conflitto sarebbe un fattore di aggravamento dell'instabilità in tutta la regione. Il lavoro degli Stati Uniti, ovviamente, da questo punto di vista è fondamentale.
U.S. role, sorry, in this is very critical.
I do not see a role in Libya. I think the United States has right now enough roles. We're in a role everywhere. So I do not see that. I do see a role in getting rid of ISIS. We're being very effective in that regard. We are doing a job with respect to ISIS that it has not been done anywhere near the numbers that we're producing right now. It's a very effective force we have. We have no choice. It's a horrible thing to say, but we have no choice. And we are effectively ridding the world of ISIS. I see that as a primary role, and that's what we're going to do, whether it's in Iraq or in Libya or anywhere else. And that role will come to an end at a certain point, and we'll be able to go back home and rebuild our country, which is what I want to do. Thank you all very much. I appreciate it. Thank you.